Hello everyone and welcome. In today's video, I'm going to teach you about Havoc Demon Hunter talents and playstyle for BFA. Demon Hunter has a lot of stable damage, but can also burst a target down quickly with their cooldowns while stunning the target. Besides having a lot of stable damage output, they have a lot of mobility and gap closes to stay connected onto their target. In this video, I'm going to cover talent choices, when to use those talents, azerite traits, and gearing, so you can keep pressure for your team with the right talent choices. Before we get into this video, it's important to note that this information has been gathered from the beta and talent choices or gearing might change in the upcoming weeks. Demon Hunters have one standard build which gives the best damage output for PvP. The standard build looks like this, but some talents can be swapped depending on what you face. The standard build provides the most damage output since it allows you to have a lot of uptime with all the mobility spells like Fellblade. The best pick in this tier is Fellblade. Fellblade offers a lot of mobility in the form of a gap closer. On top of that, it generates 40 fury, which means you can instantly start damaging the target. Demon Blades has a chance to reset the cooldown of Fellblade, which is why Demon Blade should always be picked when playing Fellblade. Demonic Appetite can be an alternative pick, combined with the Unending Hatred PvP talent. These talents combined are very strong versus Dot Cleaves, because when taking damage you will generate a ton of fury. This fury can then be used on Chaos Strike, and Demonic Appetite then has a chance to spawn a Soul Fragment after every Chaos Strike. Picking up the Soul Fragment grants you 30 fury and some health, allowing you to constantly spam Chaos Strike onto the target. Blind Fury can be used combined with Demonic to create a lot of AoE pressure. Blind Fury increases the duration of your I-beam by 50% and makes it generate fury. The Demonic talent then grants you Metamorphosis for 8 seconds after I-beam stops dealing damage, allowing you to cleave even more. The best pick in this tier is Demon Blades. Demon Blades replaces Demon's Bite as a passive ability that has a chance to deal extra shadow damage and generate fury. This will remove one global cooldown to use, which is extremely valuable in BFA since nearly every ability is on global cooldown now. Immolation Aura should be taken when you spec it to either Blind Fury or Demonic Appetite. The reason you pick this talent is because it allows you to reliably generate fury since Immolation Aura generates 80 fury over 10 seconds. The best pick in this tier is Trail of Ruin. Since Fel Barrage got nerfed, the best pick in this tier is now Trail of Ruin. Blade Dance is now your biggest damage ability, and Trail of Ruin now also causes it to leave a 4 second dot on targets hit by Blade Dance. While channeling Fel Barrage, you can no longer use any other ability, which makes it a bad talent for Arena. Fel Barrage could still be a good pick in Battlegrounds, where teams will be stacked up, for example when fighting in the middle in Eye of the Storm. Because of the momentum talent, Fel Mastery is not a viable pick, since you don't want to use Fel Rush as a damage ability. The best pick in this tier is Netherwalk. Netherwalk is great against high burst comps to make yourself immune to damage for 5 seconds. Netherwalk can be used to survive a setup while your healer is in CC, or it can be pre-used so you stay on full health while the enemy team uses their burst into Netherwalk. Soul Rending is a great pick versus Rot Cleaves, for example Shadowplay or Shadowcleave. It increases your leech, which will make you passively heal, and you will heal for a lot over time. Desperate Instinct should never be picked, since it gives you no control over your cooldowns. For example, it will proc your blur when you drop below 35%, when you actually might be fine and your healer can save you. This makes this talent very bad for PvP. The best pick in this tier is First Blood. First Blood increases the damage of your Blade Dance and makes it cause less fury. Since Blade Dance is your main damage ability, this talent is the best pick. It also makes your rotation smoother by saving fury while using Blade Dance, and this talent synergizes really well with all your azerite traits that affect Blade Dance. None of the other talents on this tier match up to First Blood and should be avoided. The best pick in this tier is Fel Eruption. Fel Eruption has a 20 yard range and stuns the target for 4 seconds on top of doing damage. This talent is great when playing with teammates who don't have a lot of stuns or when playing in a melee cleave to keep the target locked down. Master of the Glaive can be played when playing with a teammate that has no slows, for example with a Warlock. The best pick in this tier is Momentum. Momentum makes your Fel Rush increase your damage for 6 seconds after using it. It also offers reduced cooldown on Vengeful Retreat, so the standard not only increases your damage, but also your mobility. It also makes Vengeful Retreat generate 80 Fury over 10 seconds, if it damages at least one enemy when used. Meaning Momentum can also provide you with additional Fury. As mentioned before, Demonic should be played when you're looking to AoE a team down, and should be paired with Blind Fury. Nemesis should never be picked, since it forces you to train one target, which in most cases is a bad thing in Arena. So here's a quick summary of when to play what talents. Your normal go-to spec will be with Fellblade combined with Demon Blades. Against Dot Cleaves, you will want to spec into Demonic Appetite, Immolation Aura, Soul Rending, and the PvP talent Unending Hatred. When you want to AoE a team down, your go-to spec will be Blind Fury, Demonic, and Immolation Aura. You can then pick Soul Rending or Netherwalk depending on what comp you face. In BFA, you can now pick 3 other talents and choose between playing Trinket, Adaptation or Relentless. As a Demon Hunter, playing Trinket is always the safest option because you will have to rotate cooldowns and trinkets with your team. If your healer calls to use a defensive cooldown like Cover of Darkness or Reverse Magic, you can use your trinket to save yourself, which would not be the case with Relentless or Adaptation. There are some PvP talents that should be considered as a definite pick. Demonic Origins offers 2-minute less cooldown on Metamorphosis, which makes it a very strong pick. On top of that, it also offers you with 5% extra damage when you're outside of Metamorphosis, making it an even better pick. Cover of Darkness is a great defensive cooldown for you or your team. Cover of Darkness should be used for your team, since you want to use Netherwalk for yourself before using Cover of Darkness, in case one of your partners gets in trouble. There are some PvP talents that should be picked depending on what comp you face, or what comp you play. Unending Hatred is really good versus casters, especially versus Dot Cleaves, since it will grant you a lot of Fury, which means more damage. Solitude is a great pick, since it increases your attack speed and Fury generation by 10%, but can only be used when playing with a caster on your team, since your team has to stay 15 yards away from you, for Solitude to work. You should pick this talent every time when playing with a caster on your team. And last, there are some optional PvP talents that depend on preference or comps you face. Reverse Magic can be used versus heavy CC comps, for example when facing a mage or hunter to dispel CC from your healer. Reverse Magic can dispel any magic effects including dots, polymorph, magical stuns, fear or roots. Rain from Above is a great pick when you expect to be the kill target, since you can use it to avoid offensive setups. Rain from Above can be used when your healer gets caught in a CC chain to stop some incoming damage onto you. On top of that, it also deals a good amount of damage when flying in the air. Demon Hunters have 2 strong traits, which can be used to increase your damage. The best trait is Revolving Blades, and you should aim to stack this trait 3 times, which means you should have this trait on every Azerite piece. This trait reduces the Fury cost of Blade Dance and increases his damage. Since Blade Dance is your main damage ability, this trait is a lot better than the other traits after the nerfs to Unbound Chaos. Unbound Chaos is the second trait on the list, since even after the nerfs, it still increases your AoE damage by quite a bit. If you're unlucky with gearing, or can't find Azerite pieces with the Revolving Blades trait, Unbound Chaos is a good alternative. This trait works well together with Momentum, since you will constantly be using Fel Rush to increase your damage, and therefore proccing the trait. This trait can also be considered when playing a Rot comp, for example when playing with a Warlock. Try together 3 Azerite pieces with the Revolving Blades trait. If you're unable to do this, you can use an Azerite piece with Unbound Chaos till then. Every gear piece will have agility. After that, the priority list looks like this. Haste, Versatility, Critical Strike, Mastery. Haste gives you a faster global cooldown, and your auto attacks will be faster, which results in more damage. Your Fury generation is also faster when stacking Haste, which makes it your best stat. Versatility increases your baseline damage and healing from all abilities, making you more tanky when playing with Soul Rending. Critical Strike offers nothing for Demon Hunter, since you want to have stable damage and haste and versatility offer more value for this than Critical Strike. Mastery increases your chaos damage and movement speed and is not a bad stat. However, for PvP, haste and versatility simply offer more than mastery. When looking at gear, you should aim to have haste and versatility on every gear piece, preferably more haste than versatility. For your enchants, you want to have enchant ring packed of haste, which increases haste by 37 on your rings. For your weapon enchants, you want to have one enchant weapon quick navigation to increase your haste, and one enchant weapon versatile navigation to increase your versatility. If you get gear with gem slots in it, use versatility gems in those slots to increase your overall damage. The reason we recommend getting both haste and versatility as enchants is because both are equal in value. Demon Hunters have limited choice to what race they can play. For Alliance, Demon Hunters will have to play Night Elf. Night Elf has Shadow Melt, which can be used to avoid big damage abilities like Chaos Bolt, or to avoid CC like stuns for example. Night Elves also have 1% extra haste at night from the racial passive Torch of a Loon. For Horde, Demon Hunters will have to play Blood Elf. Blood Elf has Arcane Torrent, which has been changed from being a silence to a purge on a 1.5 minute cooldown. This can be used to purge important abilities from a target, for example when training a Holy Paladin, it can be used to purge Blessing of Protection if timed right. Blood Elves also take 1% less arcane damage from the passive racial Arcane Resistance. You will spend the majority of the game setting up your burst and keeping pressure for your team with your stable damage output. Since Demon Hunter has multiple talent builds which can be used, the damage rotation is different for each build. The Fellblade build consists of using Fellblade on cooldown to try and reset the cooldown from it. After using Fellblade, use Blade Dance on cooldown. Use Chaos Strike as much as possible, and use Fell Rush to gain momentum to increase your damage when you want to burst. You can also prioritize I-Beam when two or more targets are stacked to deal some AoE damage. The Demonic build consists of cleaving and getting into Metamorphosis as much as possible after using I-Beam. Use I-Beam on cooldown to trigger Metamorphosis. Use Blade Dance on cooldown. Use Chaos Strike as much as possible. Use Immolation Aura for Fury. And use Demon's Bite as a filler. To burst a target down quickly, start with using Fell Rush to gain momentum. After that, use Vengeful Retreat, followed up by Metamorphosis. This will give you a lot of Fury generation to use on Annihilation. During the opener, use Throw Glaive and Spect into Master of the Glaive. Use Fell Blade to connect onto the target. Use Vengeful Retreat to gain the passive Fury generation. And then use Fell Rush to connect back onto the target before resuming your normal rotation. Pick your talents based on what setup you face, but try to use Demonic Origins in every match. Look for gear with haste and versatility on it, get enchants that have haste and versatility, and try to stack the Azerite trait Revolving Blades 3 times. If you're unable to do this, Unbound Chaos can be used until you get 3 pieces with Revolving Blades. That's gonna be it for this guide, guys. Please let me know what you think in the comments and leave a plus kill if you enjoyed it. And I'll see you guys next time.